Okay, I'm back with the replays because I've got nothing else to do. So I just finished pushing again. I'm a little bit dead today because I've been playing a lot of Clash Royale on my alt. But a few days ago, I got four wins in a row to 7.2. I versed two hard counters right here. Those two are hard. I would show these, but I forgot to record this earlier, so the replays aren't available. The third game was my matchup. Fourth game's like 50-50. But anyway, I won all of them. And I went to push ladder today. And I also won all my matches. But the special thing is, these three are all hard counters. Like, I'm talking 100 to 0 matchups. And I somehow won all three of them. Well, maybe not the last match. The last match is like, it's still a counter. I wouldn't say it's a hard counter though. Just because he doesn't have the lightning. First match is like 90-10. Second match is like 90-10 as well. Let's start with the first one. So, I'm not sure if anyone here's watched my first balloon video, or it might be my second balloon video, but I did a run through of how to play against bait. Well, turns out this guy is a lot better at bait than the other guy. So, I actually had to try a little bit. He goes princess first play, as all the bait players do. The reason, if I knew he was playing bait, I would have cycled guards in the back or something. The reason I didn't was because he went Ice Spirit Skeletons Log, and I thought he was running, like, if he was running 2.6 or something, I was gonna save my guards for the Hog Rider. Or if he was playing Expo. Dark Goblin gets one hit. Princess at the bridge again, like all the bait players do. At this point, I'm pretty sure Princess is their win condition, not the Goblin Barrel. Because whenever they get it, they just spam it at the bridge. Here. I'm not sure how this Goblin Barrel didn't get a shot. I thought it was going to get like two shots or something, but apparently it didn't. Oh yeah, and with a Mega Minion earlier, I knew he was going to go Skeletons next with Tower, but I didn't really want to zap it because I would have been down a little bit of on Elixir, but it would have got two hits if I zapped. I got my Dark Orb in here to predict his Princess, because that's you know, following the pattern of the Princess at the bridge, I thought he was going to do it. Oh yeah, since he has skeletons instead of Goblin Gang, he has a faster cycle, so he got back to his Goblin Barrel faster than I could get back to my Snowball. Yeah, I'm not sure how these two skeletons didn't connect either. I got really lucky this game. Oh, at the start. At the end. This is why it's a 90-10 matchup. Whenever I drop my balloon, he can just rocket my balloon. There's nothing I can do. Actually, there is something I can do. I'll do it later. You get the gist of it. 1 HP balloon. And since his cycle's so fast because he doesn't have his Goblin Gang, it doesn't matter if I cycle two balloons. He'll have two rockets for my two balloons. So at this point, he hadn't put his Tesla down yet, so I thought he might not have a Tesla, and I was gonna do. I won't say what I was gonna do, but I was gonna do some fancy tricks. Just in case any log bait players out there want to use it on me. You know, I don't want to get it used on. So I keep cycling the balloons in the back from here, but it's not working. Oh, right here. Since he dropped his Tesla, I wanted to balloon in the back, but I can't drop it in the back on the weak side, or he'll just rocket the tower and the balloon. So I dropped it like next to the tower, so he can't do both. And early game with this deck, you don't really want to predict princesses because it's a huge elixir investment. But when you get later into the game, you should predict princesses because like your tower will be pretty low. Here, I get one hit. Because when the rocket hits the balloon, the tower still needs to hit it twice, or one princess and one tower, and it'll kill the balloon. But the rocket alone won't kill the balloon, so that's why I froze. I think, yeah, if he goes Tesla, I'll go Lumberjack Balloon, but I knew he was gonna rocket this. He has an interesting rocket here, though. It comes down pretty late, and the balloon gets one hit. The hit didn't matter that much though, since it was on the other side. Mega Minion to predict this princess. Because whenever they have a Tesla up, they always want to go with the princess. So instead of dropping anything at the bridge, I'll drop in the back so that by the time it gets there, the Tesla's already dead. Yeah, as you can see, I can't really break through. Not with this method either. So instead, I go with my second favorite method with balloon. The balloon at the bridge and freeze. Oh, right here, this is key. He goes with the Valkyrie, and then I use my snowball and I push the Valkyrie to the side so that my Lumberjack connects to his tower, and then I win the game. Because I thought he was going to go with Ice Spirit to reset, but the guy did a good job using his Valkyrie to push the Lumberjack off the tower. So then I pushed his Valkyrie off my Lumberjack, and the thing connected. We'll watch the second match now. This is Golem Pump. So the reason Golem Pump is such a hard counter is because... Oh, and he has Clone too. It's because the Elixir Pump, I don't have a spell for it. I can't kill the Elixir Pump and it gets infinite value. When they stack up more than one, it's already a good game. And Golem's just really hard to defend with this deck. He went Golem first play. I would have gone Lumberjack Balloon if I had it in my hand, but... Obviously didn't. So this was awkward because usually when I'm defending Golem pushes, I wanna put my guards on the support units and then freeze. But I didn't. I couldn't. Because I didn't want to leak like 3 elixir before I dropped it. But luckily this guy didn't have a tornado to tornado everything into the ridiculous death bomb. So I was alright. I didn't take that much damage. He's up 4 elixir. Oh, well, 3 elixir. He's up 3 elixir, and he has a pump on the board. I'm not sure how I won from here. So right here, I thought he was gonna have, maybe a Mega Minion, because he had a few cards he hasn't dropped yet. So that's why I went with, my Lumberjack in the back, and then my Balloon. So if he dropped his Mega Minion, I would have enough for freeze, but he didn't have a Mega Minion. I froze anyway, so... I wait until the freeze wears off and then I snowball, so that more bats walk into the snowball. This was a pretty bad Goblin Gang on his part, because I can just zap. It wasn't horrible, it was just the zap got a lot of value. But as you can see here, look at my elixir and then look at his elixir. And he has 2 pumps on the board and he's still up on elixir. How I defend this, I don't know. The reason I went to the Dark Goblin at the bridge, that was a pretty bad Dark Goblin. It was because I thought the Dark Goblin was going to kill the tower and then walk down and kill the Elixir Pump as well, but... the tower was like, it got one extra hit on the Dark Goblin. I'm not sure how I defend this push. I was pretty lucky that he dropped his clone that early, because I was about to drop my freeze right before he dropped his clone, and that would have lost me again. 2 golems on the board. I don't know how I did that. I think the only thing that's like keeping me in this game is that he doesn't have a tornado. Because if he does, all of my Dark Goblins and all of my stuff just gets tornadoed into the golems. I got the Mega Man to protect the Dark Goblins, because the Dark Goblins, since he doesn't have a spell, a spell to kill it, the Dark Goblins just get so much value. And very, very bad Golem on his part. Very bad. But I guess he had nothing else he could have done, so... Maybe, I think if he went Golem in the middle, it would have been a better play. But yeah, at that point it was a really good game. And I give him some BM because he goes Golem first play. I always have to BM the Golem first play. There's too much skill involved. This third match, it was interesting. It was interesting. Because it wasn't the traditional Golem deck. He had... I think he had E-Barbs instead of Lightning. Against most decks, that would be good. But when you're against Balloon Cycle, the Elite Barbarians are pretty useless. I was thinking of going... I thought he was playing Balloon at this point, because that's what most Balloon players do when you drop a Dark Goblin. They'll go with a Lumberjack in the back, same lane. I personally don't do that, but most Balloon players do that. Pretty bad Elite Barbarians on his part, because it just gives my Mega Minion so much value. At this point, I knew he was playing Golem, and I knew he didn't have enough Elixir to fully defend my balloon, even if he did have lightning. So that's why I went with that. He actually defended this quite well though. I didn't expect him to have that much elixir, but yeah. The point of the snowball there, it wasn't to get the balloon a hit. It was to separate the mega minion and the baby dragon so that the my mega minion could finish off his baby dragon and then kill his mega minion. I didn't care that much if the balloon got a hit or not in that situation. Typical golem players, you're up one elixir, you go with the golem. If you're equal in elixir, you still go with the golem. So unlike the last guy, this guy had a tornado. Yeah, this is what I usually want to do. Usually when they go the golem, I want to push opposite lane, but... Oh yeah, you see how I put my guards to the right? I would have mentioned this in the last video, but you want to kill one elite barbarian and then kill the other one. You want to kill them separately, because if you put your guards into the elite barbarians, they get the elite barbarians. If there's two of them, it only takes 3 shots to kill all of them. But if you kill one and then you kill the other one, it makes it so he has to hit so many more times. I was thinking of going Lumberjack Loon same lane, but I thought he might go golem in the back, so that's why I went opposite lane. He overcommits so hard on this right lane. I'm not sure why, but it works for me. His one mistake was this tornado right here. That tornado just lost him the game. Because if you think about it, how else is he gonna defend my balloon? Yeah, sure he can take half my tower, but I can take his whole tower. And since he's played all his cards, I know that he doesn't have a lightning, so I can just spam him at this point. Even if this balloon right here hadn't taken his tower, I would have cycled another one to take his tower. So the thing that lost the guy this game was because of that tornado on my Dark Goblin into this push. If he hadn't used that tornado, he could have defended my balloon properly, so. That push was a few hours ago. I'll show you my local rank. 6th. Something funny's been happening for the Australian leaderboards recently. So, there'll be days where I don't push. For example, I'll be like 7,300 right now. And then throughout the day, I'll start moving up the ranks for no reason, even though I'm not pushing. Just because everybody else is tilting. I don't know how that works, but... Oh yeah, and I'm all set for a new best finish. My old run was 2.2k, but since the season ends in a day and a half, I'll probably get a better season than that. I'm guessing around 1.7, so it's quite interesting. Yeah, I just thought I'd make this quick video. I might not make another video for a while because next season they're introducing the ladder changes and the Clan Wars 2 stuff. So next video might be in a few months or so. I'm not sure. I'll upload if I can. If you guys want to see another video, just comment. I always see comments, so see you.